This is the end of an era, guys. This will be Apple's last Intel-based iMac before they transition to the new design and Apple Silicon. So, let's enjoy it. Hey guys, how are you all doing? Really? That's just great. You know, I'm doing pretty great today too. My name is Krazy Ken, and if you're new here, man, I'm really sorry. But it's gonna be a great day today because Apple released their new iMac. I've been waiting for this for a long time. I know a lot of you guys have as well. Unfortunately, it didn't get redesigned. There was a lot of speculation about a redesign, but that's okay. I think there's a reason for that. We'll talk about that more in a little bit. That's the future. But at this exact moment, let's talk about the present. The first new thing I want to talk about is, across the whole 27-inch line, it's all SSDs, and even with the baseline 21.5-inch model, it doesn't start with a mechanical drive anymore. It's all SSDs as well. So today, on August 4th, 2020, finally, no Apple baseline Mac has a mechanical hard drive in it anymore. Like the previous generation iMac, the 27-inch iMac features a 27-inch display. Shocker. And it has 1 billion colors. It has that P3 wide color feature as well. But one new thing is it has True Tone. So the color temperature of the display will adjust based on the ambient lighting in the room, like you have on the MacBook Pros and the iPad Pros. Another optional feature is nano texture glass. This is a feature that was only on the Pro Display XDR until now. So the nano glass is, as it may suggest, glass, and it's etched in such a way where it has a matte finish. But instead of it just being a coating on a regular screen, it's actually etched to have that matte finish, which helps reduce reflections and glare, and it looks pretty nice. But you'll have to determine whether or not you want to cough up the extra $500 for that, because I think the standard display is more than enough. I use an iMac Pro all the time at a different editing location, and it's great. As long as you have the lighting controlled in the room where you have nothing reflecting and shining into your display, the standard display should be just fine. But if you want the nano texture, go for it. I'll leave it up to you. This next feature is super handy with our luxurious pandemic lifestyle. You know, you're on video calls and stuff all the time as you're working from home. The iMac now has a 1080p webcam. That's just great. You know, Apple isn't really known for making the best webcams in their Macs, but I think most webcams and computers kind of suck anyway. But Apple's making them better, and they will get even better with time when they implement their own silicon, which we'll talk about in a bit. But in this particular iMac, we now have a 1080p FaceTime HD webcam, and we also have a new microphone array, which helps capture audio much better. I'll test it for real once I have the iMac in my lair, and we'll see how good it sounds, or hear how good it sounds. So make sure to subscribe and stick around for that. But on paper, this sounds pretty good, and the reason why the computer is able to work with audio and the camera better is because it's using the T2 security chip. Yes, the T2 security chip does security things, as the name suggests, but it is custom Apple silicon, which means it can provide custom features Apple needs, just like you use in your iPhone all the time. There's an image signal processor in this iMac, which can help the camera perform certain operations, face detection, exposure control, tone mapping, and it uses all those technologies to help make a better picture. Speaking of the T2, I know not everybody loves the T2 security chip, especially the people in the hacking and modding community. And I feel ya, I get it, but we have to remember Apple is playing to the largest common denominator here, and most people are gonna want the security features that the Apple T2 security chip can offer, and they're not gonna care that it may restrict certain modding abilities and stuff like that. So again, I can level with you guys, but unfortunately, we're a minority. And Apple knows that. It's an ongoing debate of privacy versus flexibility, and I don't want to get bogged down in those details now, but I just want to let you know I can empathize with you. But the T2 chip does more than just certain security things. It actually does other features like we talked about with the camera, but there's more to it, like video encoding with HEVC. If you've seen my other episodes, you know that HEVC can be very demanding, and if you don't have hardware acceleration, like in this computer, to do HEVC encoding, it will take forever. So I'm excited to see how fast this new iMac can do that. Okay, let's talk about specs. The baseline configuration features a 6-core 10th generation Intel Core i5 at 3.1 GHz, 8 GB of DDR4 RAM, a Radeon Pro 5300 with 4 GB of memory, and 256 GB of super fast SSD storage with speeds up to 3.4 GB, not gigabits, gigabytes per second. That sounds pretty awesome, and that will run you $1,799 US. And that will ship almost immediately right when you order it. Now keep in mind, if you do what I do and you like to customize your iMac, the shipping times are gonna take a little bit longer. but they'll be worth it. Maxed out, the 27-inch iMac features a 10-core, 10th generation Intel Core i9 at 3.6 GHz, 128 GB of DDR4 RAM, a Radeon Pro 5700 XT with 16 GB of memory, and 8 terabytes, 8 freaking terabytes of SSD storage. If you take all of that, plus you add the nano texture glass and the 10 gigabit Ethernet option, you're looking at $87.99 for that configuration. As for the I/O, it's the same arrangement as before, which is nice. It includes the 40 gigabit per second Thunderbolt 3 interface, but it also features some of the slightly older stuff that makes me super happy. SD card slot, USB type A. Oh, thank you, Apple. Thank you for leaving that in there. For my personal config, I maxed out the processor, no problem. But as for the RAM, I'm okay with 32 gigabytes of RAM. This thing only has 16. I've been using it for almost 7 years. 32 should be fine. I went with the middle option video card. That should be good too. And I also only got the 1 terabyte SSD option because most of my data is stored externally on a RAID anyway. And that's more efficient for me, you know, once I get the RAID replaced that got damaged in the mail. Oops. Another cool thing is the iMac does come with a mouse and keyboard, which I don't really need because I already have a mouse and keyboard, so I'm just gonna sell them and make some money. Pro tip. Okay, so I know some people are asking, Ken, why didn't you wait for the Apple Silicon Mac? Why didn't you wait for the Mac to be redesigned and look better? My reason is, I don't care. I know that was a little blunt. I'll explain. Again, I've been on this computer for almost 7 years, so at this point, I'll take any upgrade I can get. I know there's some cool stuff coming as Apple transitions away from Intel to Apple Silicon, but as of right now, I just need a newer, faster computer. I'm still gonna use this as a field machine, but for my desktop daily driver at the home office, well, I just need something a little faster than this 7-year-old thing. Don't wanna hurt its feelings though. The other reason I'm buying this iMac now is with the new system, it's gonna have a new design and a new architecture, and you have to treat that like a version 1.0. There's probably gonna be problems. Will it transition smoothly? Absolutely, that could happen. But there could be issues, so I probably won't be an early adopter in this case. I just need something sooner rather than later and something that's reliable. I just jinxed it, didn't I? But I do wanna try the new iMac when it comes out, probably in 2021, and that's gonna feature Apple's new SoC. And I was talking about that a little bit throughout this episode, and what I mean by that is Apple currently uses Intel processors in their systems, and sometimes, depending on the model, there's a T2 chip or a T1 chip, and there's some custom Apple Silicon features with those chips. But those chips work with the Intel systems together to try to make your experience happen. But what Apple wants to do is they want to get rid of that and build the whole system on a chip, SoC, into their computer, like they do on their iPhone with the A series chips. They want to do that so you can get way better performance per watt and a bunch of unique features that you can't get with the Intel chipset. For example, Apple Silicon can offer the speed and the security needed for a true depth camera so you can unlock your computer super securely with Face ID, like on your phone. Apple can already do that on their phones because the phones are already using Apple Silicon. Once the Macs start using that stuff, you'll be able to get features like that in the future. So Apple Silicon is going to be great. There's going to be a transition, of course. There might be some bumps in the road, but it's going to be pretty freaking awesome. I actually did a whole separate episode explaining Apple Silicon, so I highly recommend you check it out. It's a good one. Let me know what you think about the new 2020 iMac, and also feel free to let me know what you want to see in the next iMac when they switch to Apple Silicon, so feel free to drop a comment about all of those things below. Also, on Thursday, or Friday at the latest, this week, I will be releasing my iPhone 12 episode, so make sure to stay tuned for that. There's some cool stuff to talk about. And when I get the iMac in my lair, I will absolutely do a full review of it, and I might even do a live unboxing. So stay tuned. If you want to get early access to those videos, plus get some other perks, feel free to support the channel with the join button below the video, or with the link in the description. And if you like the video, you know what to do. Thanks for sticking with me, catch the crazy, and pass it on.